Behold, the Lord cometh with 10,000s of his saints, to execute judgment upon all, and to convince all that are ungodly among them of all their ungodly deeds which they have ungodly committed, and of all their hard speeches which ungodly sinners have spoken against him. These are murmurers, complainers, walking after their own lusts, and their mouth speaketh great swelling words, having men's persons in admiration because of advantage. But, beloved, remember ye the words which were spoken before of the apostles of our Lord Jesus Christ, how that they told you there should be mockers in the last time, who should walk after their own ungodly lusts. These be they who separate themselves, sensual, having not the Spirit. But ye, beloved, building up yourselves on your most holy faith, praying in the Holy Ghost, keep yourselves in the love of God, looking for the mercy of our Lord Jesus Christ unto eternal life. And of some have compassion, making a difference, and others save with fear, pulling them out of the fire, hating even the garment spotted by the flesh. Now unto him that is able to keep you from falling, and to present you faultless before the presence of his glory with exceeding joy, to the only wise God our Savior be glory and majesty, dominion and power, both now and ever. Amen.
Early one morning, March 9th, 1992, I awoke from a dream, actually a nightmare, where I had seen Satan. That's all I remember. I know he had terrified me, and terrified me to such an extent that I woke up nearly screaming. As I tried to clear my head and walked into the bathroom, I felt an evil presence. It was real dark in the house, but I thought it was just because of a dream. As I come back out of the bathroom, I've seen, and some may think I am mad, I don't care what they think, I know that I know that I know, my God uses supernatural means to bring this song to this earth at this time so that souls would be saved. I saw, how do I describe what I saw? I saw what looked like dim lights in the outline of a man. It was as if a child would like connect the dots. I could see the head, I could see the arms, I could see the trunk, and I could see the legs. Why I know it's a man, I don't know, but I know it was, and he stood at the end of the hall. They weren't bright lights, they were dim lights, and they weren't connected, they were disconnected lights. And it was the height of a tall man. Well, needless to say, when I saw this, I ran to the bedroom. But that same evil presence seemed to have followed me into the bedroom. And I jumped into our waterbed, and I cuddled up next to my husband's back. And then all of a sudden, it was like I could hear Satan mocking me and saying, "We'll find no comfort there, for he too belongs to me." Then I jumped on the other side of the bed, curled up in a ball, and started quietly singing, "Jesus, Jesus, help me, Jesus, I'm so frightened, Jesus." I felt like I was a tiny little 3-year-old or 2-year-old. I'm ashamed to say how much fear I felt. A lot of things have happened to me in my life to bring fear, but I don't know if I've ever been as frightened as this. And as I was praying, I asked God, and I rebuked and I bound and I cast Satan, demonic spirits out of the house, and covered everyone with the blood of Jesus, and reminded God that I was trusting him to protect us. And as I was praying in the Holy Spirit, I also asked for a meaning of what had come and what I had seen. And then God gave me peace and I fell asleep. Only God could give us peace when we're that frightened. And only to have another dream. This time it was about a dream about what it was like when a person goes to heaven. A man went to heaven and a man went to hell. And I woke up terrified again, for I had seen a man in hell. The next thing I did was I started praying again. And I asked our Heavenly Father, what was this all about, God? I asked you to show me what spirit had come into my house. What was this all about, God? And then you give me a dream about a man in hell. What was this, God? And then my sweet Heavenly Father told me these words. He said that I had had a visitation from a citizen in hell. And he also spoke the word that I had earlier in the tape spoke about how he was going to give this song to the world at this time so that tens of millions of souls would be saved. Maybe they wouldn't come to our Father because they loved him at first, but they would come running in fear when they realized only a loving Father could save them. And he said, this is only the first level of hell. I am going to give you another song that is going to make Satan weak with rage. I look forward to that song. I have not yet gotten it. But he said, I will show you the first level of hell. Well, you see, there are many levels of hell. And Madeline Murray O'Hare and all you atheists out there, when we wonder how God could still let you live after the things you've done to him and his children, I want you to know that God gave me the answer. He said, you and the others who are destined to hell are only working your way down to the level that you will go after you die. You see, those going to hell, God already knows who they are. When they die, it's already been determined what level they will sink. But this citizen from hell had an evil presence about him, yes, because he had just come from hell. But I believe the dim lights that was the outline of his body symbolized at one time he had the light, the true light, our Jesus Christ. And of course it dimmed. Don't let your light dim. I believe with all my heart that this man was a fallen creature. And I believe with all my heart that this man, who forgot God for some unknown reason, chose this man supernaturally to bring this message to the world, what the first level of hell is like. And people, the first level is so terrifying. I don't know how the second and third and fourth, and it goes on and on, hundreds and hundreds, maybe millions of levels. Who knows? He didn't tell me this. But the first level is so horrifying. And when God said the majority are nice people, what the world would consider good people are on the first level. That's frightening. You think of hell only for the evil people of this world. You don't think of it as the people that you look at, your next door neighbor or your family member, somebody who doesn't want to hurt anyone. And yet when they die, they have done the one unpardonable sin. They refused Jesus Christ as our Lord and Savior. Maybe some of them even just had head knowledge. I know some of them had head knowledge, but many of them fill the pews this very day. And they think because they go to church and they know the Bible, they think because they belong to the right church, they shook the hands of a pastor, they give money on a regular basis, they're good, they give to charity, they don't hurt anyone, they help everyone. Oh, these poor people. These are the ones that I know Christ must hurt for the worst. For they are the ones that are more deceived than the evil ones. For they know they are reprobate. They know they are evil. How much worse it must be to think You're going to heaven. To think that all you have to do is know about the blood of Christ. And to know that Bible. And still wind up in hell. Can there be anything worse than that? But my darlings, you don't have to wind up in hell. God has said, don't just let it be head knowledge. Love me with your spirit. Love me with your soul. Trust me with your lives. Don't just know that Bible with your head. Know it with your spirit and your soul. When you sin, make sure you take each sin to the Lord. Make sure you ask Him to help you not to sin again. Turn away from that sin. Don't think you can go out and commit murder today just because you want to. You hate someone, you kill them, or well, tomorrow I can go to the priest and I can say so many Hail Marys and everything will be fine. It won't be. Don't premeditate sin. Don't trample the blood of Christ under your feet. For be not deceived. God is not easily mocked. The matrimonial heirs of this world are going to pay. Those that we look at and we say, God, they're stripping our Christian freedoms away. Why are you letting them talk against you? Why do you let them make movies against you like this? Why do you let them bash you like this? And God spoke these words and He said, they bash me now, but just wait till I start bashing back. Oh, now when on television it seems like it's chic to bash God, to hate Christianity, but it's going to turn around. And these people who have done these things, if they don't repent, are not under the mercy and the blood of Jesus Christ. They are under the wrath of God Yahweh. And Jesus can't help them, because it's already been determined. God knows who really loves them and who doesn't. God knows who's playing church and who really means church. God knows whether that book really means something to you called a Bible, or whether it's just a book that's full of fairy tales. God knows your heart. And this citizen from hell I have grieved over, as I say this now, I remember how I cried. For this man had to go back to hell. And I know he had to suffer even worse torment and persecution by the evil one. I hope somehow God said, you're not going to punish him any worse for doing this. I'm telling you, this person is as real to me as you are. I'm telling you that I wept for his soul as I do yours. This is all I was created to do. One thing. I've known it, I've felt it, and I'm willing to give my life for it. And that is to bring souls to Jesus Christ, to bring the last chances, those that have run out of chances. If you listen to this song, beware, because if you do nothing with this song and you mock the message that has been given this day, beware, you were a last chancer. You'll not only see the first level of hell, but many, many more. Everyone starts out in a waiting line on the first level. This is all God showed me. He told me He would show me more levels when I could bear it. For even showing me what He showed me for 10 days afterwards, I got extremely, extremely ill. I'll not go into the details, for I don't want Satan to remember either. But I thought I would die. Because this song is probably one of the hardest songs that God has ever asked me to write. I heard and saw in a vision, but it's just as real as looking at you, this man in flames. I heard in my head the monotonous tone of his voice with no beauty, for there's no beauty in hell, and no tune. And somehow God had to recreate what I had heard. And the only way he could do that was allow me to get very, very, very sick. And when I couldn't figure out why he wasn't healing me, you can, when you hear this voice, I've yet to be able to duplicate this voice. Praise God, I've not had to get that sick. So I've worked around that voice. And I'll tell you this, it's worth it. It's worth it to me if just one of you who do not know my Lord and Savior, if just one of you, good people, will deny Satan. What should I say? I don't know how to say it any better than to just to say, deny Satan your citizenship in hell. Is there any hope for the citizen that brought me this message? Is there any hope for him? I don't know. I couldn't even say goodbye to him. When his song was finished, I knew he wanted to come one more time and say goodbye. He walked past my water cooler. He stood right by it, and yet in hell, as this song says, there's no fluid of any kind to drink. Did my God allow him a drink of water before he went back? Is my God one day going to have extra mercy on this man? Only he knows. I wanted to pray for him so bad, and yet it was too late. When he left my home, he had to go back to the torture and terror and torment and mockery of hell itself. And this man sings his song. I really believe this. This song is being sung in hell by the citizen in hell. There's no beauty. So when you hear this voice, know that it's meant not to have any beauty whatsoever. There's not even supposed to be any emotion except for the pain. And since I've not suffered that kind of pain, and praise God I don't have to suffer that kind of pain, the Holy Ghost did the best he could to this vessel. Know this. If you belong to Jesus Christ, and you know if you really belong to him or not, you will know that you know that you know. If you die this very moment, you will go to heaven. Then you have nothing to fear. But you have a mandate to warn others, no matter if they want to hear it or not. Do you want them to go to hell and say, my sister could have told me, my brother could have told me, my mother could have told me, my best friend could have told me, my neighbor could have told me, my boss could have told me, my employee could have told me, and no one told me because they were afraid of offending me. But how much more will they be offended when they are? Even the greatest musician cannot play a piano without it being off key. Even the greatest singer, rule the claim, in hell sings flat. I repeat, there is no beauty of any kind. And the Lord showed me something else. Satan is continually mocking. Demons are continually mocking and reminding the people in hell what they are missing and how they didn't have to be there. When Satan speaks, there's an echo. So you don't only just hear it once, and you don't only hear the torment of the demons once. It echoes and echoes and echoes. Every cry of pain, every scream, every moan, every God help me, echoes. Times that billions times. Oh, the noise alone must be unbearable. You know, Satan once told me something. It's not only God speaks, but every once in a while the evil one will get in there and say something. And I'd been praying and praying for deliverance of a situation in my life, and I'd had promised from God that he was going to deliver me, and yet deliverance hadn't come. So one day, as I lay in bed and I was meditating and wondering when God was going to deliver, all of a sudden I heard a voice, an evil voice, not audibly, but those of you who have heard God speak know that he speaks to our spirit. Well, the evil one does the same thing. And he said, hey, you. He called me, hey, you. He said, I'm not going to try and get your soul, for I know I can't. It belongs to another. But I want to make a deal with you. I'll deliver you from this right now if you promise me that you will shut your mouth and not tell anyone how evil I am. Let them find out for themselves. That's what he said. I want to be a burr in Satan's saddle. I want to be a thorn in his flesh. I want God to use me mightily for his glory, to do what he has promised to do, and that's to bring tens of millions of last chancers to the feet of Jesus Christ, to snatch them right out of the fiery hand of Satan. And I am willing to give my life whatever God says to give it, to see this come to pass. For devil, you have no deal. I'll warn the people. I'll warn them of my last dying breath. No one is going to be able to say the lady in red didn't warn them. For this is all I was ordained to do and to be. I am Sister Elijah, and I am here to prepare the way for Jesus Christ to come again. And he's going to have a church, and it's going to be without spot and wrinkle. And those that you think will never be part of it will come. And those who are called the last chancers, some of them will throw away their last chance, true. But many more will take that last chance and say, God, forgive me. Thank you. Thank you for giving me this last chance. And they will be mighty, mighty warriors for Jesus Christ. For you see, I too was a last chancer. Not because I denied God, but because I tried to take my life. And because as I lay dying, many years ago now, that has always been the one thing, my greatest sin, is I thought I had the right to take my life, but I had tried it again and again and again and again, more times than I care to tell you. But I tell you this, once I became a born-again Christian, I know that God told me I never had the right to ever try to take my life again, for it no longer belonged to me, it belonged to Jesus. And old Satan, the very first night I found out that God was real and he wasn't just history, and Jesus was supposed to be my best friend, and everything I had done was under the blood of Christ. That night, after giving my life to Jesus, I'll never forget it as long as I live. I came home, I took a bath, and as I sat in that bathtub, I heard the voice of Satan. And he was angry. And he asked me, what right did I have to give my life to Jesus when he already fixed up a room for me in hell? Do you believe it? Nobody told me. Yet I was held accounted. Jesus was nothing more than history to me. As I lay dying from these suicide attempts, I would cry out to God. And I would say, just let me know before you put me in hell. Just let me know why you didn't love me. Oh, please, God, just let me know. And my God gave me my last chance. So now, I am able to speak to you, too, who are the last chances. I know what I did with my last chance. I've given it to Jesus. Won't you do the same? Listen to this song. Remember this song as I am singing it. This very moment is being sung 24 hours a day. If there is 24 hours in hell, I don't know how they keep time there. How do you keep time for eternity? And this man chose, God chose him to come back and to give this song to all of us. If you're not a last chancer and you're already bought with the price and the blood of Jesus and you know it and you know you're on your way to heaven, know this. Then you are going to be held accountable for this day to go to the other last chances. And warn them. Who cares if they're offended? You're going to stand before God one day and say, I'm sorry I didn't witness to my boss because I didn't want to get fired. I'm sorry, but my neighbor, well, I just don't know him. And so therefore, you know, I'm a little embarrassed to go there and ask whether they know Jesus, that Jesus was coming back. That neighbor is going to know when they're in hell. They live right next door to a born-again Christian. Because Satan is going to mock and mock and mock. There's nothing more to say. I am going to give you what God gave me to give you. I'm not going to apologize for the fact that many will be frightened, because I know that God's going to show me the second level and the third level, and yet I praise the God that I serve. I don't have to go there for God to show me that through song, there's going to be a song that's going to make Satan weak with rage. I'm looking forward to that song. Think of it. Weak with rage. Yes, devil. I'm going to keep on telling the people how evil you are. I'm going to keep on warning them of the flames of hell. I'm going to keep on warning them. And I'm going to keep on telling them that you have heaven to gain and hell to shun. It's truly only your choice. Because wherever you wind up, you've already made that choice while you were on earth. And God doesn't put you in hell. The people who are going to hell chose it themselves. It's truly your choice. I just want to say one more thing, and that is this. The very night this song was finished, and I believe it took 8 hours, it wasn't easy. I know that citizen from hell wanted to come back one more time and say goodbye. I'm ashamed that I left all the lights on and I ran into the bedroom. I could not bring myself to see this one more time. I did thank him as I lay in bed, and I asked God to let him know that I was grateful and that I would do what he had told me to do. But I wish I would have shut the lights off. I hope and pray some way, somehow, God was able to have mercy on this man. Maybe not now, for I know he went back to hell. But who knows when the judgment time comes? Maybe, just maybe, what he was meant to do on earth and failed by losing his own soul. Maybe, just maybe, maybe God can have some kind of mercy on him. That's not scripture, I know. But it doesn't help me from hoping. You don't know how ill he is. It could be anyone. A citizen in hell. No name. Just a citizen in hell. Please warn the people. I pray some way God gets this recorded in some way, somehow. I don't care if the world wants to mock me. Let it be played on TV. Let it be on the radio. Just some way, somehow, I pray in the name of Jesus Christ. Everyone who have heard this song. Because there are those that it will not only just be a song, but it will bring them the salvation of Jesus Christ. Others, beware. It'll only sink you lower to the level of hell. For this won't scare you either. You won't be frightened. And you will think you are macho because of it. For you, it is too late. You are called reprobate. And you are fit only for the fire. But you can't say you weren't warned by the lady in red.
Grace of Jesus Christ. The other side of this tape will go into more.
more detail of how this song came about. If you accuse me one day of scaring you into heaven, then all I have to say is blessed be the name of the Lord. At least you made it.
Yeah. Jesus Christ. the Bible says about hell. It's only the citizens in hell that have worms for blankets and sheets for maggots. Instead, I have beautiful white robes and the finest food in my own mansion with a diamond doorknob. On every door, huge pearls and gates, jewel galore. Sparkling everywhere, the sparkle wing from glittering from the jewels. Every kind of jewel that is imaginable. Streets to dance before my Lord. Pure gold, perfect health, perfect happiness and joy and laughter. No tears, no sorrow, nothing evil. For all eternity I will have no torment or fear. And only godly company, most of all God the Father Yahweh, who sent his Son, Jesus Christ, is here. They're here. This is your last chance. God has been merciful to you thus far, but God the Father's wrath and damnation is about to fall heavily. He loves you so much, he has said, give them this song. What will you do with it? Are you going to sing the song of the citizens in hell? Or will you pray with the citizen in heaven? Today is the day of salvation. Are you sure tomorrow won't be too late? By doing nothing, you've already done something. The worst sin of all. As the citizen of hell said, is a rejection of Jesus Christ. After death, there is no forgiveness for that. Are you sure you'll live another minute? Are you sure you'll live another hour or another day? Are you sure you'll have another day to say, wait God till I make up my mind? Wait God till I finish having my fun sinning? For sin starts out as fun, but it doesn't end that way. Ask anyone who's an alcoholic. Ask anyone who's addicted to drugs. Ask anyone who has AIDS. Ask anyone and see if they think sin is fun anymore. Ask a murderer on death row if they think sin is fun anymore. Ask a thief who's behind bars if sin is fun anymore. Ask a man who's caught in the act of adultery, who now sits in divorce court weeping for all he has lost. Ask him if he thinks sin is fun anymore. Do you have another minute? Do you have another hour? Do you have another day to reject Christ? Do you? It's your choice. God has said this song must be sent for last chances. This day may very well be your last chance. What are you waiting for? Do you really want to sing a duet in hell? With a citizen in hell. It's your choice.
This song has been sung to you by the Lady in Red.